Get your backpack ready. It's time to brainstorm another trip. This week, in our whirlwind tour of the history of science, let's travel to ancient Rome. I hope you'll make some meaningful and unexpected discoveries this week as we explore the strange new world of the Roman Empire. Though we have just a limited time to visit, we'll not be like tourists in Rome, Pergamum, or Seville, who seek fast food at McDonald's. Our aim will be to get to know the Roman scientists in terms of their own place and time, not just in terms of modern science. Have you seen the Pantheon in Rome? The Pantheon was a masterful ancient architectural tribute to the gods of Rome and is the best preserved example of Roman architecture today. The huge, open, spherical interior reaches exactly as high as it is wide. Its levels are proportioned according to the square root of 2. What would it feel like to enter the Pantheon? What if you could look around from inside? Have you enjoyed any works of art that were inspired by some way by the Pantheon, such as Dali's Raphaelesque head exploding? Do you read or speak Latin or Italian? If so, what are your favorite works of Latin literature or Italian stories? What most interests you about Roman history? Does Roman history have any special meaning for you? What is your favorite movie or book related to the Romans? What most interests you about Italy? Does Italian culture have any special meaning for you? Do you like Italian food? Have you traveled to Italy? What is your favorite movie or book related to Italy? What do you know about Roman science? Who is your favorite Roman-era scientist? As always, when we're planning a trip, we want to better understand what people in this place and time were up to. What are some similarities between ancient Roman civilization and our culture today? How might these similarities help us to understand ancient Roman science? What are some differences between ancient Roman civilization and our culture today? How might these differences pose an obstacle to our understanding of ancient Roman science? What do you think might be the chief barrier or prejudice that obstructs modern appreciation of science in the Roman era? Please share your thoughts on these things. What are your starting assumptions?